Welcome back. Last week, I got a request from Wonga Studio about making a burger poster. So, let's try it in Gimp. Let's create the canvas, go to File, New, and I choose this plain A4 and hit OK. After that, let's import the image, go to File, Open this layer, and choose these images. Okay, then let's scale it around here. Okay, let's change this color to red by create new layer and name it background color. And let's change the color with this red. Okay, and fill it with this bucket tool and make sure you're active in this background color layer. Then click it. Now let's change the mode into burn. Let's decrease the opacity so we get the texture of this image with red color. Now let's add the burger. Go to File, Open this layer, choose this burger. Let's scale it up. Place it on here. Let's make the burger match with the background color. Go to this color, levels, and adjust it. Let's set the fire behind the burger. Go to File, Open this layer, and choose this fire. Let's move the layer below the burger. Place it here and scale it. Place it here. Let's duplicate the fire layer to the left and right. Alright, duplicate it and move it here. Scale it. And duplicate this one. Move it here. Next thing, add the lens flare. Go to File, Open this layer, and choose this lens flare. Place it to this tomato reflection. Let's change to white color. Go to color, curves, and just make it to the top. Just hit OK. And let's reduce the opacity a little. Next, let's add some text element to this top and this bottom. Alright, go to your text tool and let's type some. Change it to white. Okay, I'm using this railway font. It's free for personal use and commercial use thanks to the creator. You can download in the link description. Now let's change the house color to yellows. Okay, let's increase the font to 300. Let's place it on here. And let's increase this house text. And now let's reduce this space by go to here and make it -100. Okay. Let's increase more. Run here. And let's shear it with the shear tool. Just drag it to the top. Run here. And hit enter. Let's add another text element. Go to your text tool again. And let's type. I'm using this Alec brush. This font is free for personal use and commercial use thanks to the creator. You can download in the link description. Let's increase the size around here. place it on here, make it shear tool, go to your shear tool and just drag it to the top. Okay, for the last text to this button, go to your text tool and let's type change the font type to this railway medium. Okay, now let's add the brush stroke effect to this and this. Now go to file, open this layer and it's just this brush stroke and scale it. Let's send this layer below this burger house text so we can preview text. Now go to your shear tool and just drag to the top like the font. Okay, let's make it larger. Now let's change this brush stroke color. Go to this layer, right click, choose alpha to selection, and okay, let's find the dark brown color around here. Go to edit and choose this fill with foreground color. Same steps for this one. Go to file, open this layer and open this 100 brush strokes. You can download in the link description and choose what you like. I choose this 16. Let's change the brush stroke color to this dark brown. Same step, right click, add alpha selection, go to edit, fill with foreground color. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new about compositing and images in Gimp. Comment below if you have any question or request what design to do. And hit like if you like this video so people can easily find it. Don't forget to subscribe for make sure you are in update about this Gimp tutorial. It's Zakey Design. Create something good today.